Hello students, welcome back in English grammar class. This is your teacher Miss Hifsa. Today we are going to discuss our last topic as a part of speech because it is the eighth part of speech, interjection. Let's first define it. An interjection is a word that expresses strong feelings. Like these are such type of words which expresses our strong feelings, which expresses our emotion. When we feel something and those sounds just came out of our mouth. So those are called interjection. Let's discuss it in detail. An interjection at the beginning of a sentence is followed by an exclamation mark or comma at times. At times they are followed by a comma when they are not that much higher, when expressions or emotions are not that much higher, so it is followed by a comma. But when it is more strong, so then it is followed by the markup exclamation or exclamation mark. You can see it. Wow, that was the best goal of the match. Here the word wow is an interjection and it is followed by the markup exclamation. Oh, I forgot to bring my book. So here at the end they have put an exclamation mark because obviously it is an exclamatory sentence. But here the word oh is just followed with a comma because here it is not showing that much high frequency of our emotions. Great, we can leave now. So here the word great is followed by the exclamation mark because it is stronger. Interjections are not words. Do remember, they are not words. They are connected as other parts of a sentence. They are not words, so they would not be connected as other part of speeches are connected to each other, but merely sounds standing by themselves. They are just sounds which are standing by themselves. Like as you know, noun is modified by an adjective, and an adjective is modified by an adverb, or a verb is modified by an adverb, and an adverb can also be modified by another adverb, or preposition shows us the position of noun. So these are all interconnected with each other, all other parts of speech. A conjunction join two words, two sentences. So they are interrelated or interconnected. But here they are saying that interjections are just those type of sounds which are just, they stand by their own. They are not connected with the other parts of speech in a sentence. Interjections are also used to express some types of emotion such as disgust, joy, excitement, enthusiasm. They just shows our emotions, like when we are excited, when we are happy. So those words which we utter from our mouth, so those shows our emotions of excitement or emotions of happiness or emotion of sorrow. So those words are interjections. Interjections have no grammatical relation to any word or group of words in the sentence. As I told you, they are just standing independent elements. That's why look at the examples. Alas, this is the end. So here the word alas, after this the word we have the word this, and the letter T is capital. Why? Because it is completely an independent element. It is not depending on the rest of the sentence, otherwise then we would not capitalize it. So it seems that the word alas is another word separate, and this is, from this the sentence is being started. Same look at another sentence. Hey, do you know where you are going? So here the word hey, it is an interjection, and it seems as if it is a separate or an independent element from the rest of the sentence. Then oh, I can't believe that. Here the word oh is an interjection, and it is written separately from the rest of the sentence, and the sentence started with a capital word after that. Interjections are also often used as addition to words such as nouns, pronouns, adjectives, and some other parts of speech. At times we have certain type of interjections as well which have a meaning. Like look at it, good, it is a word, good, it has its meaning, but here it is used as a interjection. Or look at another one, great, keep up the hard work. Here the word great or will, when do you intend to pay for it? So look at the word will. Good, great, will, these are common words, but they are used here as an interjection. So sometimes such type of words are also used, they can also be used as an interjections, and they have a relationship, and they add something more to the nouns, pronouns, or adjectives, or some other parts of speech. like as here the word good, I am thrilled to hear that it is showing us that someone have heard something and they are just expressing the emotions related to that. So these are different words. Now here we are discussing that how we punctuate the interjection. If an interjection is spoken calmly, as I told you earlier as well, if they are just spoken calmly, simply put a comma after it and continue the sentence. Like they are, if they are just not spoken that much loudly, they are just spoken calmly, so then we put a comma after this. Like look at the sentences here, the word is shh, the baby is sleeping, shh, the baby is sleeping. So here it is just a word which we are just speaking it calmly. As you know, we are wanted to make someone keep quiet, so we use this word. So we just put a comma after it. Look at another one. Oh my god, I dropped my pen. Like here, if a pen dropped from someone, so it is not that much big deal that we were showing our emotions or our strong feeling. So that's why we have just put a comma after this. Oh my god, I dropped my pencil. Okay, then if an interjection is spoken with more emotion, I told you, if it is our emotions are more strong, it is followed by an exclamation point. The next word is then capitalized. As I told you, then we put a mark up exclamation after the strong emotions, and we capitalize the next word in the start of the sentence. Like look at it. Ouch, I just cut my finger. Obviously cutting finger, our emotions are just strong and we just shouted at that, ouch. So here look at the sentence, the first alphabet of the sentence is then capitalized. He scored the winning touchdown. Wow. So here the wow is also showing the strong emotion. Here we have a list of some common interjection, and they have also given the description that for which purpose we use it. Oh, it is used for sudden realization, like when we suddenly came to know about something. Ouch, to express pain when we hurt ourselves or we want to express the pain, so we just use this word, ouch. Then the word shh, used to make someone be quiet. Wow, amazement, impressed, or astonished. When someone became amazed, impressed, or astonished, so then he or she used this word, wow. Hooray, it is used for joy. Eve, it is used for disgust or dislike. When we dislike something, we just said, Eve, I don't like it. Okay, then we have the word her, asking for confirmation when we ask something. So this word is used when we say it like this. Then we have the word alas, these are for sorrows. Oops, surprised, are acknowledging your own mistakes. When you are become surprised, so we use this word oops, or when you acknowledge your own mistake that you have done something wrong, so you use this interjection, oops. Okay, this was your today's topic. Hope it would be clear to you. Can you tell me some more interjections? So that would be your homework. Just write few more interjections which are used commonly in our daily life. Thank you for watching. See you in my next lecture. Have a nice day.